All right, time for the list.
All right, so this time it came up with family brushes with fame. I think everyone has a story of someone who met someone famous, except for Pat. He didn't
have any of that.
So the first one, I'm going to start off because I've told this story in the past, but you know, maybe some people haven't heard this. Back when I was in the radio with Jonathan Brandmeier, and he had that big fight with Donny Osmond and Danny Bonaducci, you know, where they fought each other.
Yeah.
So I'm doing traffic on his show. I'm standing backstage at the China Club, and Jack Brickhouse was brought in to announce it.
Wow.
You know, because he used to do boxing announcing before he worked for the Cubs.
Yeah.
So he's getting ready to go on, and I'm just standing back there, you know, and he starts going, like, he's going to spit.
A loogie.
Yeah.
And so he turns around, like, not looking, you know, and lets one fly, and it lands right on my shoe.
That's repugnant.
That's a great
story. So that was my big brush with Jack Brickhouse.
And you say anything to him, or
no,
you just go
home
with the loogie?
Like, he's a big deal. I'm just like, I kind of slid over and kind of kicked it off my shoe and just went about my business. So there you go.
That's a great brush
You're
with
welcome.
Fame.
All Good right, so you. Larry, you've got one with your mom.
Yeah. That's the lady there on the left is my mother.
All
As a teenager, she dated Tony Conigliaro in high school, who went on to be was a pretty big star at the Red Sox, and then his career ended when he got hit in the eye. Otherwise, he would have been a really big star. He had like 25 home runs in his second year in the league or something. And so anyway, it was short-lived, but you know, you take what you can get when we're talking about brushes with fame.
But he met your she met your dad. She's like, this guy's got to go.
Yeah, my dad was a much better dancer. and this one, oh, there's my dad there with the afro.
Yeah.
So he used to work for this company that would put on, not like the auto show, but it was like the fashion show. So you'd buy a booth. And so this guy came in, and he says, oh, I want to come in. And my dad said, you just can't come in. He says, well, I'm Kramer. That's the guy in the lower right. I'm the guy who Kramer is based on. I'm the real Kramer, the guy who lived next door to Larry David. And my dad said, I don't care who you are. You can't come in without a
bench. He probably said it exactly like that, too.
Yeah.
I don't care who you are.
So a brush with fame is the real Kramer that the famous Kramer is based on.
Wow.
Gotcha. And Paul, you've got one too.
Yeah, so my brother and I think maybe at the end of high school, started up this little business where we're going around the nice neighborhoods in Naperville, washing windows and cleaning gutters. And we got hired to wash windows at this house, and it turns out to be the house of Bears place kicker Bob Thomas, who was a great kicker for years, has went on to become the Illinois Supreme Court Justice here in our state up until a few years ago. My sister wound up becoming his nanny for a brief period of time. He gets cut by the Bears, goes plays in San Diego for the Chargers at the time, and my sister has a brief date with their punter, Ralph Benerschke. So that was a double. We got Bob Thomas and Ralf Benerschke.
Oh, that's a great name.
Two names I know nothing about.
Yeah, Bob Thomas is a big deal. Yeah,
that's
Notre
amazing.
Dame guy. Great guy.
All right, so Patrick couldn't
think
of one.
I mean, I
had to dig deep into my family. So here's my dad on the left. He tells this story about when he was a tile salesman and he's visiting one of the tile stores in the 70s and Barbara Eden is there. Don't ask me why, but that was big. She was just off the dream of a genie.
Sure.
So my dad's like, I don't know what to do. So I'm just walking and she's kind of walking around looking and he goes, you got any grout?
Use that one all the time myself.
Logical question.
And she just, you know, kind of ignored him, and he always kind of regretted that he kind of flubbed that whole thing and he didn't know what to do.
Mrs. Chance.
Next one, my sister, you know, that's my sister Becky and I had a couple of brushes with fame. First off, she's at, like, you know, on the plane, she gets bumped up to first class somehow and is sitting next to this guy who's pretty nice and just chatting. They get off the plane, her daughter's, you know, in the baggage claim. She's like, you were sitting next to Coach Q the whole time.
And she had no idea.
She had no idea. And then the same thing happened when she was on an elevator, when she was out in Los Angeles. Jay Leno gets on and she has no idea. And then other people start going, he goes, hey, well, how about this? It's an elevator. She had no idea until she got off the elevator.
Huh.
So I'm like, you just got to start paying attention a little bit.
Yeah.
And now I'm going to end with one of my favorite all-time brushes with fame stories.
Okay.
Buzz Killman, who I worked with for years on the Jonathan Brandmeier show, always told this story that I just thought was the coolest way if you ever interact with a celebrity. He's walking down Oak Street, and he sees Tommy Lee Jones, the great actor, walking in the opposite direction, right? And he's like, I love Tommy Lee Jones,
yeah.
You know? And if you know Buzz Kilmer, he's a very cool character. He's like, I'm not going to say anything, but I gotta
yeah.
tell him
yeah.
how much I...
Right.
So he goes, when we got side by side, I just looked over and pointed at him and said, big fan. And he pointed back at me and said, thank you. And that's all you need to do.
Yeah, that's it.
Just
that's
let him know you appreciate their work and just keep on walking.
There you go.
I thought it was the greatest story.
That's so great.
There you go. That's the list.